So a lot of people call in with different questions about RFID. They want to use RFID to improve their operations, whether it's retail management or they're hosting an event, and they want to keep track of the people that are attending. And that's great because so many different businesses have used RFID to improve their operations. So they look around and they see a whole lot of different types of tags, antennas, and readers, and they don't know which one's the best for their situation. And they don't know what they're supposed to do. The answer is testing. See, testing is a low-cost, efficient, and simple way to see if your idea for RFID can improve your operations without having to spend a whole lot of money. Testing is so important because there are so many different factors that can affect your ability to capture reads. The environment in which you're reading the tags in, orientation of the tag on the object being read, antenna gain, and reader settings are just some of the factors that can affect your ability to capture reads. Also, there's not one specific tag, reader, or antenna that's best for every single situation. See, every business is unique in some way, so all of these products have been created to fit a very specific need. So before assuming that RFID is right for you and spending a whole lot of money on antennas, readers, tags, and the software you need to get it all started, you should start small. RFID tag sample packs and development kits are a great place to start. Tag sample packs can be customized to your specific application by combining an assortment of different tags that should work well in your situation. Now, during your testing, a sample pack can help you eliminate the tags that don't work as well as that one that was meant for you. I have with me four different kinds of development kits. I have a four-port reader development kit, a development kit with an antenna integrated inside of it, a USB reader development kit, and a handheld reader development kit. The four-port reader allows users to attach multiple antennas to a single reader. Now, depending on your reader settings and setup, you can attach between 4 and 32 antennas to the single reader. And that gives users a lot of flexibility when they're trying out different antennas for the application. Depending on the reader that you choose, you have the options for power over Ethernet and Wi-Fi capabilities. The integrated reader development kit is a lower cost option than the four-port reader development kit. It has an antenna integrated inside of it, as well as an additional antenna port to attach an additional antenna if your application calls for it. And like the four-port reader, it also has power over Ethernet and Wi-Fi capabilities. The USB development kit is the most affordable option of all the development kits. It's great if you're just getting into RFID and you want a low-cost option to test around with. Now, because of its small size and power output, it has the least amount of read range of all the readers. And it also is a serial reader, so it has to be connected to a host computer, unlike some of the other RFID readers. The handheld reader is a mobile RFID reader with an antenna integrated inside of it. It's great for applications when you're on the move and you can't be restricted to a single point of reading. It can also read a couple types of barcode, and because it's a full-fledged mobile computer, it's typically more expensive than the other RFID readers. As I mentioned before, development kits and sample packs are great for testing because it allows users to try out different approaches to various different applications. Now, thank you for taking the time to watch this video, and if you have any other questions, please send us an email at info@atlasrfidstore.com. Have a great day.